Both teams are lining up for the kickoff. We're just about set to get this one underway. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Gain of 6 on the draw play.
That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's to the 40. He's into the open field. Inside the 30. The 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown. The halfback got the carry and weaved through that defense for a score.
He found some daylight and took off for 6.
Converts the extra point. A short 2-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success, but these guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
The score now, 7-0. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And down he goes at about the 43-yard line.
I'll tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. 3, maybe 4 yards on the pass.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up. Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
From their own 47-yard line, second down. He's gobbled up in the backfield. That took a little too long to develop.
Yeah, the offense was trying to get the pass rush going upfield, but the defense did a nice job of sniffing out the draw play and hitting him in the backfield.
He lets it fly, and they intercept it. The sophomore safety.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
From their own 21-yard line, it's first down. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled right around the 38-yard line. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 37-yard line, third down. is incomplete. Great range as he's able to break up the pass.
I know that the safety makes a good play here, but as a receiver, you got to get in there and play some defense. He's lucky that one wasn't intercepted.
Hirsch waiting the return. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. They'll bring him down at the 15. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Bates picks up about 4 yards on the play. From their own 19-yard line, second down. Got it to the senior. He's tackled around the 30-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Gets to around the 42. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 42. Gives it off. And he gets a yard on the run.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and 8.
Not that impressive of a play. Let's see if they continue to employ the short passing game or if they decide to run the ball.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Made right around the 30. A good looking pass that time.
Well, here they do a nice job of getting the ball out to their speedy receiver. And he shows you that he not only could turn on the jets, but he's got pretty decent hands as well.
Slings it. Brought down around the 14-yard line. And this is the 8th play of the drive. It right, nice pickup. So he calls his own number and gets about 6 yards. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Tackled after decent pickup. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Through a defender, and he's in.
Really good vision here by the quarterback and a good understanding of where he was on the field. He didn't need much, and he knew he could get it himself.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 86-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And they can forget about returning this one. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. He's got to his tight end, and he's taken down at about the 29-yard line. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Offense.
So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. It's first down and a lot. We've played one. We're even at seven in this one. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. And the defense made a big stop on fourth down the last time this offense was out there.
Now, the last time this offense was out on the field, they went for it on fourth down, Brad, and they came up short. I think as an offensive coordinator and a play caller, you've got to be very selective on when to go for it and when maybe to just punt the ball and change the field position.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 27. Play action here. He's going to scramble. Excellent open field tackle. And that brings up fourth down.
Great stop by the defense. They played with tremendous character on those downs.
Hirsch, the return man. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. From the 15. And he's tackled at the 21-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Slings it. And they couldn't hook up on that one.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guys' hands.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. He's got his receiver with nobody around him. And they push him out around the 39-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Slings it right. Tackle at the 28-yard line. Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Taken down in the backfield.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
He's at the 20. He's taken down at the 17-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. The 10. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. The stop at the 4. This is the 8th play of this drive. And it pays off. Touchdown. And Once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
Yeah, he has a lot of freedom to make plays like that, and he can do it because of his athletic ability. The coaches recognize that, and it's proven to be successful.
And he adds the extra point. An 8-play, 80-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 14-7. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Makes it out to about the 33.
That's a gain made on the play. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Quickly to the tight end, and down he goes at the 39.
That makes it first and 10.
Got his man, can't tack on any yardage.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And a quick throw, and he tackles him hard at the 40-yard line.
That's a deep 14 yards on the way. First down.
Just throws this one away. Second and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. Fires it out.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision making.
6 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Man left, man left. I got you, 18.
On play action. Gets to that quickly. And he's tackled right around the 16-yard line.
Getting the ball to your tight end and allowing him to make plays in the passing game can really open things up on the outside for your real speedsters.
Quick pass, knocked out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards.
From the 12-yard line, second down. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 7-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive. Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. So a 10-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
He's scrambling. He's tackled around the 30-yard line. He must not have seen anybody open on that play.
Nobody open downfield, but he's got to be careful. I like his toughness, but those kind of hits are going to take a toll on him eventually.
Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. He scrambled. Tackled. tackle made around the 31-yard line. And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled it.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
He gets rid of this one.
That's exactly how they drew it up in the sideline, and now they get the ball back.
Makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Receiving team.
Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws it in a hurry. Right down around the 45-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
There's a very impressive open field tackle. We played a half. 14 apiece.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. Both quarterbacks remaining upright and healthy. In fact, they haven't been breathed on in the first half. Neither team has allowed a sack, and it really speaks well for the relationship that the quarterback has and the feel that he has for his offensive line.
No, absolutely, and we always talk about those guys and going out to eat. Well, let me tell you something. They're earning a big, fat steak dinner, and those fat guys get the porterhouses, too. They're not a cheap date. Those guys, they're earning it right now, keeping me up and right, keeping the quarterback upright, keeping him clean, you know, not letting anybody hit him. You've seen great Hall of Fame quarterbacks turn average when they get popped and when they get hit and when they get, you know, beat around a little bit. These guys, they haven't even been touched. So you can go ahead and say check, please, right over here, because that QB better be taken care of.
And the quarterback's calling home, Mom, Dad, please send money. David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's taken down at the 20. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter, and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Complete. He's got room. And he is drilled at the 26-yard line.
Number seven on the tackle at the 26-yard line.
So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Mike four.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it 3-3.
From their own 31-yard line. First down. He's to the 40. Gets to around the 42. Out to about the 42-yard line. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. He steps out at the 46. Fourth and long here after the sack. Booming kick. He got hit hard.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it second and goal.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. With room to run. And he's taken down at about the 45. From their own 45-yard line, first down. He's at the 30, and he's tackled at the 18.
First down.
First and 10, let's see if they can build off that great run.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
And he's level at the 3.
First and goal.
First and goal from the 3. They're knocking on the door. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked.
That brings him second and goal.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 7-yard line. He's hit and taken down. And this is the 8th play of the drive. Defense and their short yardage package. Down. And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 78-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive. Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. They're just just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Got a man. Watch out here. That will play action good for about 4 yards.
Good job by the quarterback to put the ball right in the hands of the big tight end there.
From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Caught, and this is going to be a first down.
Of speed and strength that this cornerback plays with. He's a real valuable part of the defense.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. They'll bring him down at the 45-yard line. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 21-14, Cavaliers. Just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Two down. Mike four. Ready.
We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. So they're going to go for it here. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle at the 40.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
And they make the stop at around the 38-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. From the 38-yard line, second down.
Three down. Ready, team. Rush.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
That would have been pretty remarkable if he'd managed to hold onto the ball after taking a shot like that.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Caught, open field. He's taken down around the 28-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28. There's a strike complete. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
That's a nice completion, but give the defense a lot of credit. They weren't fooled at all. They were able to hold him to a short gain.
From the 25-yard line, it's second down. He's on the run. Inside the 10. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Scrambling. Makes a move and he's in for the touchdown. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 12-play, 76-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Steps out of bounds at the 27. From their own 27-yard line, second down. Going deep, lays it out there. That close to being intercepted.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That is not easy to stop. The quarterback hit his man on an out route, and the defender was in man coverage. As a defender in man coverage, you cannot get beat deep. And as a result, the underneath routes are going to be there. And as you can see, it worked out great for the offense as they were looking for a new set of downs.
Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Just under three to go in regulation. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. That's a deep one. That'll make it third and one. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 46. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Picked off. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Throws incomplete, intended for his wide outs.
Number 4 was the intended receiver.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. To go long and does. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Number 24, the intended receiver.
From their own 20-yard line. Second down. That's a great tackle at the 12.
That'll bring up third and nine.
He sails it long.
Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one.
And this one is a beauty.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Late in the fourth quarter now, tie football game. And if we're headed to overtime, I hope it's going to be as good as what we've seen through four quarters.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 40-yard line, second down. Makes the catch and look out. And they push him out at about the 31. Under a minute left.
The defense is making great plays here late in the fourth quarter in a tie ball game. And the question now is which offense can rise to the occasion.
So the kicker's on, and this kick is for the lead. A miss, and it will most likely mean overtime. It's up, and he just drilled it from long range. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
This has been a great game, and it all comes down to this. Who can prevail, the offense or the defense? We're about to find out who's going to win it in this drive.
He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled right around the 40. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. Good tackle there in space.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. Scrambling around, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. The spike will stop the clock.
That'll make it third down now, and they need to get it to the 17.
He's going right. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Young was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and 13.
The kick is away, and he got it! Defense calls a timeout, and it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership.
He airs it out. Doesn't get there. That's the end of the fourth quarter, and we are headed to overtime.
And we're back ready now for overtime.
one's going deep to the end zone. He scores. What a play. And he converts the extra point. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. Nice play to set up first and goal.
Tight ends can really be a wild card in any offense. Sometimes the defense are a little bit confused on how to handle them.
First and goal from the three. Let's see if they can muscle this one in. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. Be tied with the extra point. He makes the PAT.
The tension is going to rise a little bit more now. We'll see which team can overcome the pressure.
First and 10. Ball on the 25. Deep ball, laying it out there. Can't connect. Passes it to the middle of the field, and he's taken down at the 10-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 10. He scrambled. And down he goes at the 2. So they draw first blood here in double overtime.
Avoiding field goals in overtime is just huge. Anytime you can get 6 in overtime instead of 3, you're going to be tough to beat.
And he adds the extra point. It's first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's pushed out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
They come out in an empty backfield. He dives and he'll be marked down. It's second and goal. Ball on the 1. And they'll score. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT.
Just like we talked about earlier, now that we're going to a third overtime, the offense must go for 2 if they score a touchdown.
First and 10. Ball on the 25. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 14-yard line. Taken down immediately.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
From the 10-yard line, it's second down. Under heavy pressure. Tackle made at the 1-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
They're crowding the line. Swings it to his tight end, but he drops it. It's second and goal. About a yard to Pater. And he hits him hard at the one. Touchdown. So with a first possession in the third overtime, this offense takes it in for six.
There's no resting easy yet. They still have to stay on the field and try to convert a very crucial two-point conversion.
And he's in for two. From the 25-yard line. First down. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And they make the stop at about the 5-yard line. Second down. They'll bring him down at the 2-yard line.
It doesn't seem like anything is enough to put this game away, does it? I can't wait to see what happens on this two-point conversion.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. And it's caught for two.
They'll live to fight another day with that conversion, or at least another overtime period, but they don't have time to celebrate.
This has just been an incredible game as we head to another overtime period. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's taken down around the 17-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He did not get to the first down marker. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25. Tackle at the 12-yard line. Just throws this one away. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Zips it to the back. This one is over.
What a game. Just a grueling fight all the way. These guys walking off the field shouldn't be hanging their heads at all, because this was a spectacular game on both sides. But for these young men to pull it out, man, they've got to be elated.
That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, the Cavaliers 52, the Cougars 49. That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.